So the long journey to the summit of European football starts with the opening fixture of the Champions League. The atmosphere, the sense of expectation, fevered, frenetic. This is the one fixture they all wanted to see, and every day has only fanned the flames of expectation. And so the distinctive sound of the UEFA Champions League anthem. The teams line up. There's the whistle, and here we go. Jim, you've played in games of this nature. Who can make the difference?
The exciting Ivan Perisic. Tall and rangy, but he has a deft touch and enough pace to move clear of attention. He's always looking to shift the ball onto that left foot too. Catch real power.
Yes, he'd be my pick too. It's going to be all about how they get the best out of him. Messi.
Pushed both fullbacks into quite advanced positions here.
Yeah, that's interesting. So face to face with the keeper. He's gone for it! Goal! Barcelona! Barcelona are in front! Perfect placement, the one place the keeper couldn't reach.
Well, you know, sometimes it pays off not to think too much about things, just put your foot through it and that was a good example. Great contact, and the keeper had very little chance.
Barcelona get themselves into the lead.
Listen, when it comes to goals, Peter, in this team, he's always the number one contender, and he's done it again.
Over to the left. Perisic looking to get on the end of this. He's gone for it! It's in! Inter are back in business! Given such an open invitation, he was always going to shoot.
Well, considering he has a bit of a shoot-on-sight policy, he was the one player that should have been picked up then. It was both careless and costly from where I'm sitting.
That has certainly made things interesting.
Yeah, it's always a dangerous time when you've just scored. You can easily lose focus and then bang, you take back again.
Messi. For a goal. Rakitic. Rakitic. There he goes, motoring forward. And the finish! Goal! Barcelona! And they've got their lead back.
The understanding between those two plays a big part in that, and releasing the run on side proved the key ingredient.
Barcelona go into the lead.
It's so often the case with goal scorers, little influence, and all of a sudden, bang.
Bershelko passes it through. Oh, well intercepted, really alert to the danger. Rakitic.
I think that defence there thought they were in good position and they had it where they wanted, yet somehow he's worked the scoring position and it didn't see him on. It's really crafty business now.
Barcelona two up and into a position of real strength.
Listen, it's up to them now how they think about it from here, because for me it's crying out for them to force the issue.
He could have been in, just needed a better final ball.
Barcelona just had to make the ball stick, but came up short.
Played out to the right. A real chance to break. Looks to slip it through. The shot's on! They are rampant! And already they're looking to run away with it.
Barcelona are really pouncing on any stray passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heaven.
He's made it three. Quite a day at the office for him.
Oh, this has been an immense contribution from one player. He's been just about unplayable.
And it's half-time here.
Well, I've seen very little to indicate a comeback in this one, Peter. They've committed to this game with
goals. It's so easy on the eye and promises more of the same after the break. So we're just settling back into this second half. Played down the flank. He'll have a dip! Your thoughts?
There's the obvious danger man here, and yet he's afforded way too much freedom. I think he was gifted that goal. His reputation should have been warning enough for them.
So, just a consolation, or is there a way back from here? Question, that's a foul. Resisted the temptation to go to his pocket, it's just a stern lecture.
Inter making a fresh attempt to release someone in behind from back to front, and this is something different.
He's got away. Jordi Alba. Ditch defending, but that'll do. He's having a look round. Nainggolan played into space out wide. Well, they could break here. Forward it goes.
Schalke. And it's Keita.
Tries a through ball. Icardi. Assistant referee has his flag raised for offside.
It doesn't take much sometimes.
Barcelona can make their change now with a break in play. Oh, terrible mistake. Just the goalkeeper to beat. He's had a shot. That is brilliant. Mauro Icardi. Just one in it now. The game takes on a whole new complexion.
I think he just thought about trying his luck from further out there, but why bother when you can worm your way through a defence like that? It's terrific play to get through and score.
He snaffles his third, and that earns him the match ball.
Well, he's been the outstanding player on the pitch, devastating in front of the goal. What a display, what a player.
Into Milan, get themselves back into contention. Shoots!
Well,
Perisic. Looks like a good ball through, and it's got through. It's there to get rid.
Peter, they have to fight the onset of desperation and keep enough cool heads to still deliver.
Now it's Luis Suarez.
There's a real appetite from them to finally put this game to bed, but will they?
Oh, well defended, that had to be done.
Inter need to give it everything they have, kitchen sink included.
It's one! Michalko gets good distance on it. That's been one straight back. Barcelona just have to run down the clock.
Andreva
with the ball through. Can he find... Has a hit! And he's there to make a great save.
The keeper really dug out his defence then. A magnificent effort. I think you have to admire his willingness to keep plugging away, but the manager...
Up to meet it! That is it. The equaliser just wouldn't come. It is over. Pretty much the ideal start. Win on the first day, a platform on which to build. Any thoughts on today's game, then, Jim?
Well, pressure can quickly build on you if a positive result isn't achieved in your opening group match. Instead, they can take great confidence now from a very good victory